Christiana.
Nice to meet you. My name is Linda Filippi, and I'm 24. I'm here from Columbus, Ohio. This is my mom, Tony.
Hi, Mom.
My baby sister, Gina.
Hi.
My older sister, Sarah, and my aunt and my godmother.
Hi. So what are we looking for?
I like the sweetheart neckline,
okay.
And I kind of like the ball gown. My sister, Sarah, wore a huge ball gown for her wedding. It was the most gorgeous dress I've ever seen. I want to top that because that's how I want to feel.
And what do you ladies see her in?
I would like something fuller. I think that's what she looks best in.
Okay.
What she wants, she can have, I guess.
Okay.
But I'll tell her if it looks best.
I always feel like since Sarah's the oldest and Gina's the baby, that they get more of the attention.
Linda being plus size, she got a double dose of middle child syndrome.
Now that it's my wedding, I want all of the attention on me.
So where are you comfortable price-wise?
No higher than 4,000.
No higher than 4,000.
Yeah.
That's perfect. Hey, ready?
Yep. My fiance's name is Chris McWilliams. My family's big and a little bit dramatic, so he kind of keeps me grounded. He's my other half. I can't imagine my life without him.
Tell me about your wedding.
It's gonna be about 500 people. Yeah. Chris and I both come from big families.
You need a wow dress.
Yeah, I need a wow dress.
I mean, it's a big wedding,
yeah,
so.
Yeah, my sister had a wow dress, so we need to top her. When my sister Sarah put on the dress that was the dress, my mom cried.
The tears just flowed. We all knew that that was the dress.
That, to me, is what I need. I want the spotlight on me, and we have to go above her.
Making, you know, your bridal appointment kind of a competition is not the best way to go about finding your perfect dress.
So we're looking for a ball gown or something like a little bit more of a drop waist, which I think is to look nice on her.
I'm nervous that I'm not gonna find the right one.
Her biggest fear for her wedding is that she will never find a dress or ever feel beautiful because she's too big to fit into them.
I really like it. Gina, I just saw a look. What don't you like?
I just don't like that beading.
It's too plain.
I think the back is just a little plain.
I don't like the top of it at all.
You don't like the top of it?
It was just very plain, and I just didn't think it was very flattering on her.
I like it.
I think you like it for all the wrong reasons. This is the first dress, like, you were actually able to... They had it...
To try on, yes.
Just saying.
Ouch. That's not the kind of response that you're looking for somebody that's supposed to be supporting you in making this really important decision.
I like the dress, but when I looked more closely at it, I understood where they were coming from.
Take it off, next one.
Without her family's approval, Linda has a change of heart.
I hope you like the next one better. Yeah, I don't like it.
Tell me why don't you like it?
I don't like this up here. They're big enough, they don't need any more emphasis. And I don't like this right here. I don't like that one.
You don't like the ruffles?
Yeah, not the ruffles, I don't like that material. But I'll try it, I mean.
Right.
You can definitely laugh if I love it. I have no problem with that. I don't think this is gonna go down. My biggest fear is that I'm gonna get stuck too. I'll just let you know that. Let me see the front of it.
You look like a ballerina.
I do, and I don't want that. I'm feeling a little confused just because there are so many dresses and they're all different. No. What I thought I was gonna like, I don't like.
Out in the salon, the bride's family waits patiently and understands she's not easy to please.
She wants to have more of like the beading, but she doesn't want to say too much about it. She wants to have a loud dress, but she doesn't want it to like totally scream. She wants it to be like a yell, but not a scream, if that makes sense.
When my client doesn't want to leave the room because she feels uncomfortable, it just makes me want to try harder. It makes me want to find a dress that she's going to feel beautiful in. You have to remain positive because you have to have her trust you in helping her find the perfect dress.
Okay, maybe. I'm feeling a little confused about the fit and flare.
Give it a chance.
Yes, it's not at all what I pictured myself in. I like it and then I don't like it. Yeah, I'm even borderline, I love this one and then I hate it. Can we see what they think about this one?
Unable to make up her mind, Linda needs her family to be the judge.
I like that one.
I like that one, Lynn. Oh, I kind of think
it.
I'm loving it.
This was way past the like mark for me. It was more on the love side.
And you fixed that dress, Lynn.
I like that dress, too.
I thought we'd get a cry at least out of this. A tear, maybe?
Maybe a tear.
When my sister put on the dress that was the dress, my mom cried. And that, to me, is what I need. There's no tears. This is not it.
One of the biggest problems with Lynn defining a dress is she is trying to, you know, recreate that experience that her sister had.
Tears mean approval, and I wanted tears.
It's not about you anymore, it's about your sister, and it really spells disaster.
I like it. I have a feeling they're gonna love it.
And with two strikes against her, she hopes the third dress is a winner.
That's so pretty!
I told you.
I like that dress, but that dress reminds me of my dress, that's why.
That's what I was thinking too. You like this dress because it looks something like yours, just not as good as yours.
It is, you're right, that's why I like that dress.
This one is hers, but toned down more, and I don't want that. I already told her about my need to top her.
Trying to beat your dress.
My cousin called my dress the princess side dress, so yes, beat that.
I think Sarah feels that I'm not gonna find her dress that's better than hers, but she's got another thing coming, we will.
With sibling competition heating up, Christiana tries to keep the focus on the bride and pulls a dress with a slimming silhouette.
I am very scared slipping into the fit and flare, but once I looked at myself in the mirror, it was really surprising that it looked the way that it looked. I would not think that this would make me feel thinner. I would borderline say that I love it. I feel great in it. I say that I may feel a little sexy in this.
All right.
And that's not a term I use.
Bride Mandy is here for her fitting, but it's been a year since she's seen her dress.
The worst case scenario is that the dress doesn't live up to all the hype that we've given it over the past year.
Hello.
My mom and sister sit speechless. They both tear up.
It is absolutely gorgeous.
It was exactly the validation I needed.
Been a year and it's
absolutely gorgeous. I think it's even prettier
even
now.
More gorgeous.
Upstairs, Bride Linda is ready for waterworks.
All right, go ahead and open.
I like that, Lynn.
I like that, love.
I'm kind of on the fence.
But her family's reaction is not what she hoped for.
I don't know.
That's not what I wanted. I thought that my mom would definitely cry, but it fell flat for them.
If Linda wants to find her dress, it's really critical that she listens to her inner voice and really trust how she feels in the dress.
I think it's what I want. I just expected tears and I didn't get them.
She does need to see those tears to know that that's the right dress for her.
That's what it is in this case.
You can always come back.
Yeah.
Until she gets the perfect reaction from my mom, we will be on the hunt no matter where we have to go.
That hunt continued in Ohio without any luck. And 5 months later, Linda returned to the salon.
Guess who?
Ooh, I'm excited. Before I left Columbus this morning, my fiance said to me, if you don't come home with a dress, there won't be a wedding, there will be a funeral, because your mother and your sister will kill you.
So Linda's mom and sister Sarah brace themselves for yet another round of dresses.
It falls flat.
Yeah.
I think the dress needs a little more. We're in the right neighborhood. We're just not at the right house.
It has been beyond stressful.
This dress buying process is like passing an act through Congress. Oh my God.
Beep, beep.
And just when they thought they'd seen every dress in the stockroom,
we can't make a third trip back.
Christiana brings in something new.
I like that, Lynn.
It's different. It's not anything I expected.
I like that, yes.
I couldn't stop looking at myself. I knew that that was the dress I was supposed to marry Chris in.
Absolutely beautiful.
Yeah. I'm very happy that she's found a dress that she loves because she's always had a problem finding sizes to fit her.
Finally, Linda got the reaction she'd been waiting for.
That's it.
Look, she's crying.
Linda's mom cried today, which was very happy tears.
Yeah, that's what I had you pictured in.
When my mom cried, I think that it kind of solidified for me that I had found the right dress. I kind of felt like that was her approval.
Are you saying yes to the dress?
I am saying yes
Yay!
To the dress.
Yay! This just makes my day.
I'm just happy that she looks beautiful and she knows she looks beautiful.
We found it.
And Linda learns a valuable lesson.
It's not all about outdoing my sister. It's about what's best for me. I'm so happy.